Hey, it's going to YouTube Story Knows Best here. Breaking news here. Next generation iPhone has been actually captured by the folks over at gizmodo.com, a very good tech website. I follow a lot. I'm giving them all the credit for breaking this story. But they came out with this story and some action video of the next generation iPhone, or supposedly the next generation iPhone. Now, for the past couple weeks here, people have been putting up these pictures of the next generation iPhone. And when I see pictures of rumors, I'm not really 100% sold on them. I'm still on the wait and see. But after seeing this actual video of them holding the phone, actually breaking it down, I'm pretty sold that this is the next one coming from Apple here in June or July. Now, definitely looking at the design of it, it's a definitely different take on the design than the 3GS. It's not all plastic anymore as far as the back. It's kind of a squared off type of phone. It's kind of more compact. And the side of it is all aluminum on the side, and the buttons are now aluminum and all that stuff. Now, the back is still retains the plastic back that you find on 3GS to help with the cell phone reception, of course, because aluminum is not that great for it. But it, you see, it's a little bit more blockier than the 3GS. Now, it kind of looked weird to me at first, but now I look at it, and now I see why. They definitely add more rooms for the more components that they added to this next generation iPhone. I can see why they went towards this type of design, and it's kind of growing on me. But let's get to what's actually new in this thing that they actually uncovered from getting hands-on that you want to know about. Now, it does feature a front-facing camera on the front, which is also a video camera on the front. They definitely help with that iChat and all those iChat clues that we've seen in the 4.0 software update. This definitely gives reason for it. It is a front-facing video camera. The camera on the back is noticeably bigger than the one on the 3GS, so that would hint towards a higher megapixel count for the camera. I would say at least 5. I'm probably shooting towards 8 megapixels in the camera on the back, and it does have flash as well. And it does have an improved display. Now, the only display that can see on it right now, as far as looking at the display, is just a connect to iTunes logo. I mean, you got to sync your iPhone to iTunes in order to use it for the first time. Kind of the backstory because that. Now, let me tell you how they found the phone. They say they found the phone in the bar, so the idiot who found it is probably dead somewhere now. he actually left the phone in the bar somewhere. And after Apple got word that it was actually stolen or lost, they remotely wiped and killed the iPhone itself. So this is the only screen that they can see right now, just connect to iTunes. But comparing it to how it looks on the 3GS, they do say it does have a higher resolution. Even though now, on this phone that they're holding, they say the screen size is actually smaller than the 3GS. But I will take that any day. I'll take higher resolution over a smaller screen. Not too much smaller, but over a slightly smaller screen any day. It looks like it does also have a secondary microphone at the top of the phone for noise cancellation, something that the Nexus One does. And it has split buttons for the volume buttons. Power, mute, and volume buttons are all metallic right now. So, yeah, whatever. Now, they actually went into this thing and actually opened it up and looked into the insides. And they said that looking at the insides, it definitely looks like Apple's handiwork, Apple's craftsmanship. And it'll be very hard for just some regular Joe out there trying to play a prank or do a rumor to really pull off this. So that's what gives this article a little bit more credibility. But when it got inside of it, the one thing that they really noticed is that the battery is 16% larger. And I would think they would have to improve that. And I'm really liking that they did that, especially when multitasking coming with the 4.0 software update. More battery life is always better. And and they said the internal components have all been shrunken and just kind of minimized to make more room for the battery as well when they got broken into it. But this is definitely, it right here. And another thing they put into it, they said John Gruber, who's a very good connected with Apple, has already confirmed that Apple has been reported this prototype of this phone has been stolen. So this looks like this is the real thing. And this looks like a very finished product. Doesn't look like something they're beta testing or a prototype for like 2 years later down the road. This is like something they're ready to launch right now. And the fact that they were trying to disguise it, they had an iPhone 3GS case on the outside of this phone, and it looked exactly like a 3GS. But when they took that case off, it definitely saw a new product, got a nice little surprise. I'm really to give this little article here about 90% credibility that this is the next iPhone from Apple. So check out, I'm putting a link in the sidebar for gizmodo.com to get look at the article in full and watch all the videos in full length. And definitely I'm going to be right now starting the first prayer for the guy that lost the phone. Steve Jobs probably has him locked up right now, surrounded by a bunch of PCs and blue screen of death, or doing something to him in Antarctica somewhere. But definitely keep the prayers for the guy that actually lost his prototype. But anyway, Soldier Knows Best here, keeping you updated first on YouTube. But go check out gizmodo.com for more information. But thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later. Peace. Can't wait.